Tesla FSD Beta is now available to all owners in North America who ordered the full self-driving package. It is no longer restricted to drivers with a high safety rating. Tesla has frequently released new software updates to the FSD Beta program in order to improve performance, with the goal of becoming safer than human drivers and attracting more owners. Welcome to Tech Heaven, and in this video we'll take a look at everything you need to know about the Tesla FSD Beta wide release to North America. FSD Beta allows Tesla vehicles to drive autonomously to a destination entered into the car's navigation system, but the driver must always remain vigilant and ready to take control. Despite its name, it is still considered a Level 2 driver assist system, because the driver is responsible, not the Tesla system. It's been a two steps forward, one step back type of program, with some updates seeing regressions in driving capabilities. Over 100,000 Tesla owners have participated in the program over the last 6 months, but Elon Musk stated that FSD Beta would be available to every owner who purchased FSD Beta in North America by the end of the year. Finally, the wait is over. Elon Musk confirmed on Twitter recently that full self-driving beta is now available to anyone in North America who purchased the FSD suite and drives a qualified vehicle. Musk attributed the achievement to Tesla's Autopilot AI team. Tesla Full Self-Driving Beta is now available in North America to anyone who requests it from the car screen, assuming you purchase the option. Congratulations to the Tesla Autopilot AI team on reaching a significant milestone, Musk penned a letter. Elon Musk has predicted the wide release of FSD Beta several times in the past, and his predictions have generally been inaccurate. This was one of the reasons why his predictions during the Q3 2022 earnings call that FSD Beta would be widely available this quarter was met with skepticism. We expect to launch full self-driving beta in North America this quarter, so anyone who has ordered full self-driving will have access to the FSD Beta program this year, most likely within the next month. So obviously, anyone who buys a car and chooses full self-driving option will have that option available to them right away, Musk said during the third quarter earnings call. Surprisingly, the Q3 2022 earnings call was held just over a month ago. So in this sense, Musk's estimate of FSD Beta being widely available in about a month was correct. Numerous Tesla owners and software tracking services such as TeslaScope reported the wide release of FSD Beta hours before the CEO confirmed the update. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic, a number of Tesla owners who recently received FSD Beta said that they were surprised because their cars had less than 100 autopilot miles. Other owners who had safety scores of less than 80 in their vehicles reported receiving FSD Beta as well. For the time being, it appears that the wide release of Tesla FSD Beta will involve the distribution of version 10.69.3.1. Elon Musk previously confirmed that the FSD Beta version 11, which uses a single software stack for both city and highway driving, began rolling out earlier this month. This version of FSD Beta is also expected to be released soon, though it will most likely be limited to veteran testers who have been with the program for years. Tesla's FSD Beta is one of the company's most important projects. Previously, the CEO stated on a podcast that Tesla's ability to solve self-driving problems would be the difference between Tesla being worth a lot of money or worth basically zero. If FSD Beta is widely released, it will provide Tesla with a lot more training data, which will help the company develop and improve the system even more. Tesla owners who are just getting started with FSD Beta should exercise extreme caution when using the system. While FSD Beta allows vehicles to navigate both city streets and highways, it is not yet a hands-free autonomous driving solution. As a result, drivers must remain prepared to take over control of the vehicle at any time, similar to basic autopilot. If the system detects improper use, FSD Beta users may be suspended. Of course, it's a little more complicated than that, as some older purchasers who prepaid for the full self-driving beta software are still waiting for the software version that will be enabled on their vehicles, but at least they'll know they're eligible. Those on the most recent 2022.40 software branch will have to wait for the single-stack FSD Beta version 11 to be released, But for those under 36 branch, Musk says that the full self-driving beta is now available to anyone in North America who requests it from the car screen, assuming you have purchased this option. Tesla has been gradually preparing for the wider release, resetting its safety score strikes and promising a true self-driving service by the end of the year. Unfortunately, Elon Musk appears to have gotten ahead of himself with that level 3 wish. As Tesla's autonomous driving software is still mandated as a level 2 solution that will require driver attendance for the foreseeable future. Even in the United States, where Tesla has logged millions of miles in its self-driving AI mainframe, regulators are unlikely to grant it full self-driving status anytime soon, let alone the rest of the world, where the software isn't even available yet. Nonetheless, Tesla intends to compensate for its level 3 and 4 regulatory certification challenges by releasing the finalized single-stack autonomous driving model with the FSD Beta version 11 in time for the holiday shopping season. A growing number of Tesla owners who purchased the full self-driving suite for their vehicles have reported receiving FSD Beta access. This was despite some owners claiming that their vehicles had less than 100 autopilot miles and a safety score of less than 80. The update was eagerly awaited because it was the first version of the advanced driver assistance system to use a single stack for both city and highway driving. Later tweets suggested that Tesla would broaden the release of version 11 before Thanksgiving, a sentiment that the CEO recently reiterated. While reports of version 11 being received by Tesla's veteran consumer FSD beta testers have yet to be published, a growing number of Tesla owners have shared on social media that the vehicles are receiving an update that allows them to access FSD beta. However, it was FSD beta version 10.69.3.1. Some Tesla owners have reported that FSD Beta 10.69.3.1 has been installed on vehicles that are rarely used or have a safety score of less than 80. This included a driver who regularly drives his race-spec Model 3 Performance on the track, despite having a low safety score of 62. Several Tesla owners who purchased FSD several years ago have also reported receiving the update recently. Tesla's software tracker, TeslaScope, was among the services that announced the general availability of FSD Beta. According to the software tracker, Tesla appears to have removed some of the FSD Beta program's requirements for its users for the time being. Overall, Tesla's strategy for the wide release of its FSD Beta appears sound, as it would allow new users to test a version of the software that has already been tested by veterans. Longtime users, on the other hand, can try out the system's most recent and ambitious version yet. Given the goal it replaces, we wouldn't call that a major milestone. 1 million robo-taxis by the end of the year used to be the goal. Then it was 1 million FSD beta users by the end of the year. Everyone who paid up to $15,000 for the full self-driving package now has access to a beta version of the program that does not deliver on the promised performance, it now says. Based on what we've heard about the FSD take rate, that's probably nowhere near a million people. That is hardly a significant achievement. We don't even know if this move will double the number of people in the beta program. In any case, we don't see a clearer path to self-driving with this major milestone. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. But before that, we'd like to know, what are your thoughts about FSD beta wide release? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.